everyone. My name is AJ Rivera, and I am a student at the London School of Theology, helping at Christchurch with the youth. Welcome to the Daily Reflection. We're going to be looking at the book of Ruth today, specifically chapter 1. And as I thought of the book of Ruth and what I could share today, I thought about what we're going through at the moment and how many of us might have been experiencing loss, whether that is loss of a job, loss of a loved one, mental health deteriorating, possible eviction. It's a lot of intense things that are happening and a lot of intense emotions and a lot of grief and sadness. And in the book of Ruth, we find a character that knows exactly how that feels, and that is Naomi. So the book of Ruth has two main characters, Naomi and her daughter-in-law, Ruth. So the beginning of the book starts out with Naomi losing everyone that she loves. She loses her husband, she loses her two sons, one of which Ruth was married to, and she loses her house. So she decides to go to her hometown. She decides to go back to her hometown because she doesn't know what else to do. And when she gets there, she is so sad that she asks people to not call her Naomi anymore. Naomi means pleasant. And she decides that people should call her Mara, which means bitterness. And this is the reason that she gives. For the Almighty has made life very bitter for me. I went away full, but the Lord has brought me home empty. The Lord has caused me to suffer. And the Almighty sent such tragedy upon me. This is how Naomi feels. And it's not necessarily what actually happened, in that God didn't punish Naomi. God wasn't making Naomi suffer, but that's how she felt. Naomi felt faithless. The amazing book about the book of Ruth is that this is not where the story ends. This is not where Naomi's story ends. Ruth marries this amazing man that is very good and very wealthy. And in chapter 4, Naomi is so blessed. She talks about Ruth as being worth to her more than 7 sons. And it just speaks of abundance. Naomi ends up being, Ruth has a son, and so Naomi ends up being the great-great-grandmother of King David. That's how blessed she got in a matter of speak. And so even though Naomi had lost faith in God at the beginning of the book, God never lost faith in Naomi throughout the book. So if that's you today, if you're feeling tired and faithless, I just want to encourage you that God has not lost faith in you. God still has a purpose and a plan for your life, just like he had a purpose and a plan for Naomi. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much that you are good and that you are God, even in the midst of the hardest circumstances and situations. And I just pray for all of us that might be discouraged at this time, that you will fill our hearts with your joy and your hope, and that we would have a glimpse of the future that you have for us, that you have intended for us, that you've planned for us since the beginning of time. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. God bless you, everyone.